Good morning, students. In the today's class, we'll discuss about switching networks, that is unit number 5, lecture 1. So in this today's topic, we'll discuss about grading. So before defining the grading, we have to define two more terms, that is availability. What is availability? Before defining this, you can see this one more point here. If you take any exchange or some cross point switch, it contains some incoming trunks and some outgoing trunks. Here, even though if it is a fully available switch, this incoming trunk may not need to access all the outgoing trunks. It should need to have access to all the outgoing trunks. Since it's fully availability, this inlet can access this outlet, this outlet, this outlet, and so on, any outlet. But since exchange may use a stroger or a cross point switch, generally if you use a stroger, it is going to have an hunter which is going to hunt for a free outlet. So generally it is going to start from first outlet, not randomly pick the outlet. It is going to scan for a free outlet from starting to the ending. So before reaching to the ending trunk, okay, it may get a free outlet. Therefore, in generally, it is going to utilize the first choices of outlets for establishing the connection. Therefore, the last choices of outlets are having less priority for establishing connection. So that means, from this analysis, we came to know some information that the number of outgoing trunks to which an incoming trunk can obtain connectivity connection is called as availability. Okay, the number of outgoing trunks to which an incoming trunk can obtain connection is called as availability. For example, so this inlet can able to access 5 outlets. Then we can say that the availability is 5 because it can able to access 5 outlets. The number of outgoing trunks to which an incoming trunk can obtain connection is called as availability. Okay. Next one is grade of service. Grade of service means it is defined as the number of calls lost to the number of calls offered. Generally, this value of BOS is having some ranges, some 0.1 you can take, 0.01. Generally, in our topics, we are mainly focusing to design our system with the point Norton blocking probability or grade of service. Grade of service or blocking probability, we will say. Okay. So, after discussing this information, we start our concept of grading. So, principle of grading. So, for this explanation of grading, first I am taking 20 trunks with the availability 10. That means any inlet can access only 10 outlets out of the 20. So how to divide these 20 trunks? Because availability is only 10, so take 10 outlets, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 10. And second group, 1, 2, 3 and so on, 10. 11, 12, 13 and 20. So here, either the incoming trunk can select either these 10 outlets or these 10 outlets. So for that, I am taking a switch here. This is called as group 1. This is group 2. You can say like this. So from this diagram, you can say that the incoming trunks can able to access either these 10 outcoming trunks or these 10 outcoming trunks with help of this group selector switch. If it is choosing this one group, means out of these 10 it is going to choose one, because the given that the availability is 10. Here I am writing it as 1 to 20, but it may be anything. You can able to access any trunks, but the availability is 10. So you can also take this fashion also. Like this is 1, 3, 5, some 7 and 19, 2, 4, 6 and 20. But the number of outlets are 10. So the incoming trunk can either able to access these 10 trunks or these 10 trunks with the help of this switch, group 1 switch or group 2 switch. For example, for the same diagram, if you take, it has availability of 5. How it is modified? So for 5 means you have to divide it into 4. And one more point, number of groupings also depends on another formula. We will come to the point in after the few slides. The number of groups, that is the greater groups, is obtained from some formula is there based upon the availabilities and number of trunks. We have one formula, that is G is equal to 2n by k, is one formula is there. We'll derive this formula, where n is number of trunks and k is availability. So, but to get the optimum value of grade of service, we are going to use this formula of G, nothing but number of groups. And moreover, this number of groups should be an even number. Okay. So, this is, so from this, the point here is, here I have to note down two more points. One is high choice trunks. Another one is low choice trunks. So what is high choice trunks and low choice trunks means? So whenever this incoming trunk want to access any one of the outlet in either of the groups, it is going, this selector switch is going to start from first. In this order only it is going to select. So if it is busy means it is going to choose this one. If this is also busy means it is going to choose next trunk. If this is also busy means it is going to choose next. So before reaching to the last choices, so the first choices itself, it can able to establish connection. So we call them as high choice trunks and low choice trunks. Out of these three trunks, let I am assuming that 6 trunks are high usage trunks, and I can take it as 4 as low usage trunks. Okay, so I will try to modify these gradings to obtain a better grade of service value. Let us assume this entire system is having a traffic of 8 erlangs. Generally we measure the traffic in terms of erlangs. Okay. Let us assume the central system is having a traffic intensity of, it has to handle a traffic of 8 erlangs. Since it is divided into two groups, so this has to handle 4 erlangs traffic and this has to handle 4 erlangs traffic. Okay. So with the help of 10 trunks, it has to handle 4 erlangs traffic. So we have one table is there for fully available traffic, finding the grade of service for how many number of trunks are required for a given traffic with the given grade of service. So this table gives that traffic capacity table. This is called as traffic capacity table for fully available groups. Okay, so here from this one, we are interested to find for 0.01 grade of service value. So where you can see here, so for 10 trunks, this is for number of trunks, for 10 trunks it can able to handle 4.5 erlang traffic. But from our observation here, with the help of 4 trunks, it is time transit is going to handle only 4 LRMs. Therefore, it is not having good grade of service value. So, I have to improve this value further by reducing the number of trunks. 20 trunks are there, but this, with the help of 10 trunks with fully availability, because you are utilizing the same, this group can avail all the availabilities, outlets, that is called fully available. This can handling only 4 LRs. So, with some means, we are going to improve this value. So, for that, the idea here is we are going to connect the low choice trunks. That means these low choice trunks are common for both the first group and second group. Okay, these common trunks are called as commons. The name here itself can say that common, commons and individuals. Individuals. Where is it, these two terms here, commons and individuals? So here the first 6 trunks are called as individuals and the 4 trunks are called as commons, because we are going to short circuit these 4 trunks, last 4 trunks, which are called as low choice trunks. Therefore, these 4 trunks are common for both the groups, hence the name commons. How many commons are there here? 4 commons are there. How many units are there here? 6 in first group, 6 in second group. So totally 12 singles or 12 individuals plus 4 commons, that is equal to 20. Okay. Now we'll see in detail this one. So this is 16. No. 12 plus 4 is 16. Now with the help of 16 trunks, we are handling 8 LRMs traffic. If you see the table, so for 15 trunks itself, we can able to handle 8.1 LRMs. Therefore, it is somewhat better than the previous case. There it is 10 and 4.5, it is 16 and 8. Compared to this, this is better performance. This is having good rate of service values with a less number of trunks. Now we'll see here the diagram one more time. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Numberings we'll do later. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is first group. Group 1. And this is group 2. With the help of the switch, we are going to select either one of the available trunk. Similarly here also, I can connect any one of this trunk to this incoming trunk with help of this group selector switch. So here, the idea here is, these are the highest priority, highest usage trunks, 1, 3, 5 and last 1 are, last 4 are 19, 17, 15, 13 and 11. So these 4 are the having low usage trunks. Similarly here, so the second group 2, 4, here it is 20, 18, this is 16. I'm drawing it somewhat faster. First stage. This is 1, 3. This is 19. 17, 15 and 13, this is 12, 16, 2, 4, 20, 18, 16, 14, 12. So these two are the low usage trunks. So what can I do now? I can make them common for both these groups, for group 1 and group 2. Like this. Short it. 13 and 14 are shorted. And 15 and 16 are shorted. And 17 and 18 are shorted. And 19 and 20 are shorted. So this is called as full diagram. Now for this you can also draw the grid diagram. So first of all, how to draw the availabilities? The availability is 10. So draw 10 trunks in each group. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So totally 20 trunks are there. And for each group the availability is 10. So 10 in first group and 10 in second group. Give the numberings. This is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 14, 17, and 19. Second group, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. So from this what can say, last 4 are shorted. That means common for both the groups. So common them. So 18, 20, 17, 18, 15, 16, and 13, 14. So here we call them as singles or individuals. Okay, we call these last 4 as commons because both are common to. This is because these are common to both the groups. Here we use one more terminology called as doubles. Why doubles? Doubles means 2. If I am connecting, making common the 4 means it is called quadruple. So singles, doubles, quadruples based upon the number of groups. Okay. So the process of, okay, the process. So in this case, what is our total trunks value? Total number of trunks is equal to singles plus doubles have take. How many singles are there here? Total how many singles? 12 singles are there plus double is 4. That is equal to 16 trunks. Okay. For getting the same availability of 10, we are using 16 trunks only in the second scenario. So for second scenario of 16 trunks, what is the topic here? For 15, 8.1 is for full capacity. Traffic full capacity for full availability. But we are getting the same 8 trunks for 16 trunks. One trunk is more than this one. Therefore, it is a good design when compared to the previous design. With the 4 trunks for 4.5 trunks for 10 trunks is there, but we are getting only 4 trunks traffic. Okay. Now, so the process what you are doing of interconnecting these groups is called as grading. The process of interconnecting the groups, okay, for obtaining the required availability with the minimum grade of service is called as grading. Interconnection of trunks based on the above principle is called as grading. So here grading can be done in different ways. We have a progressive grading, skipped grading, and homogeneous grading. So the idea in progressive grading is in the previous case what we said, the probability of choosing the successive outlets is common, right? Because here it has to choose for first outlet, second, third, and fourth. Here are choosing the outlets in order. Hence it is called as progressive grading. Progressively accelerating the outlets. Hence the, but is it because of the reason we are saying that first 6 trunks are having highest choice compared to last 4 trunks, because it has to select in an order. But in some scenarios where we can select the outlets randomly, in that case we cannot apply this principles. It may use either first trunk or seventh trunk or tenth trunk, whatever it may be. Random it may choose the trunks. Okay, so in case of progressive gating, we are assuming that this selector switch is going to choose the outlets in a sequence manner. Okay, so that is the reason why we are commoning the last four lowest trunks for both the groups. Okay, so in order to form a grading, the switch is having access to the outgoing trunks or multiplied to a number of separate groups known as graded groups. You see, right, for out of 20 trunks, availability is 10, and have taken 2 groups to did this. So here we call those 2 groups as graded groups. So here also we have to find the value of G. Graded groups count we have to find out. So for that, design a grading to provide access to n outgoing trunks from switches having availability of K. So for this, first we have to start from number of groups. So from that we have to move. So first, what I will do, first step is decide the number of graded groups G. Okay, so how to find this means, if you assume all are having, if the grading is drawn with the help of only individuals. What do you mean of individuals? These are called individuals. They were not taking them common to any other groups. The trunk is dedicated only for that group. That is called individuals. If you are assuming that all the trunks are having individuals. So in that case, what is the number of... if all the choices were individuals, then the number of trunks should be how much? GK. G is the number of groups, into K is the availability. In the previous case, 2 groups, 10 trunks, so 10 availability is equal to 20 trunks. Nothing but this one only. Number of trunks is equal to groups into availability. Okay. If the choice were all fully common, that means all 10 are common, then what is the value? N is equal to K. Number of trunks is equal to K. The previous case it is 20, now it is only 10. For every example. Therefore, based upon the number of singles and commons, the value of this may, the number of trunks may vary in between these two values, 20 to 10. Therefore, the value of trunks may vary from K to the GK values. So, to get the optimum value of trunks, because the number of trunks are too small also, it cannot able to handle traffic properly. So, we have to choose the optimum value of number of trunks. So, the value is GK by 2. Okay, the reasonable choice for n is GK by 2. So, from this you can find the value of G as G is equal to 2n by K. G is equal to 2n by K. Always this G should be even, because there is a symmetrical connection, gradings. And for 2 groups, how many solutions are there? Only one solution is there. That is K is equal to S plus C. Availability and number of trunks is equal to 2S plus C. Because 2 groups are there, 2 into number of singles. 2 into number of singles. Because these singles are available in both the groups. Hence, we have to take 2 into number of singles in each group plus how many commons are there? C is the number of commons. Because 2 trunks you are taking it as common, so plus C is going to give the total number of trunks in case of a 2 group. You can also find it for here only one solution is there for 2 groups. If the number of groups increases, okay, we are having more values, more solutions are there. Out of the more solution, how to choose the best possible solution. Okay, here you have to find the values of D1s and D2s and D3s. if it is having some three different solutions, out of the three dish, we have to choose the best value. So we'll come see that how to find this value. Some example. So the grading has more than two groups. There is no unique solution. We have different solutions are there with the different singles, different doubles, different quadruples, and so on. So here the traffic offered adjacent outlets will be not differ greatly because you are taking it in order way. So therefore a smooth progression is used here for finding the optimum value. Now we'll see designing a grading for connecting 20 trunks to switches having 10 outlets. Okay, here designing grading for connecting 20 trunks to switches having 10 outlets. That means this availability value is 10. So first what have to find out? We have to find out the value of G. How to find G? G is equal to 2N by K. That is equal to 2 into N is 20 by 10. That is equal to 40 by 10. That is equal to 4 groups. So we have totally 4 groups are there. Okay. Now, what have to calculate? We have to calculate how many singles are there, how many doubles are there, and how many quadruples are there for a better grade of value, grade of service value. So, first we have to obtain the expressions. What is the value of K here? We can take how to get the K value, singles plus commons plus doubles should be equal to the availability. This is the first equation we have. Okay. What is second equation? Second equation is, since it contains 4 groups, so each group contains some singles. So 4 into singles, number of singles in each group. Use total number of singles in all the 4 groups. How many doubles are there? See, here, two groups are there. I am giving some example here. If I am not taking any common, so in this one, there are 4 singles are there. What about doubles? If I take in common, these two trunks in first group, two groups, and these two trunks in second group, 3-4 group means, it is contains 2 doubles. What about this one? If I am taking common all the trunks means, it contains 1 quadruple. So now how to find the number of trunks here means 4s plus 2d plus q is going to give the number of trunks. Okay, here how many equations are there? 2 equations are there and 3 unknowns are there. So it is difficult to solve it. So, I have to use another mechanism and I have to get another equation to solve the problem. So, apply the same thing for our problem. How many trunks are there? N is equal to 20 and K is equal to 10. So, for these two values, we have to find out a successive progressive grading and we have to find an optimum value. Optimum values of S, optimum value of C, D, and optimum value of Q. Okay, so S plus C plus Q is equal to how much? 10 is our first equation. Second equation is 4S plus 2, this is D right, 2D, doubles, 2D plus common quadruple is equal to 20. Now do 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1 what will get? 3S plus D is equal to 10. Take that as equation number 3. Now we will have 3 equations, 3 unknowns. Now we get the value. So from equation 3, what we can write? So here we are getting some 3 equations. Now our object is to find out what is the value of S, what is the value of D, and what is the value of Q. That is given the optimum value of grading, grade of service. So for this, we have to do some trial and error method. That is, let take S is equal to 1 So for s is equal to what is the value of t, you will get 3, 10 minus 3 is 7, t is equal to 7. Substitute in your equation number 3, I am getting it as 7. Now substitute s is equal to 1, t is equal to 7 in equation 1, what is the value of q will get? Q is equal to 2. And let take s is equal to 2, what is the value of d will get? 3 2s are 6, 10 minus 6 is 4, and q is equal to how much? 4 plus 2 is 6, 10 minus 6 is 4. And let s is, take s is equal to 3, what is the value of d will get? 3 3s are 9, so d is how much? It is 1, and q is how much? 3 plus 1 is 4, so q is 6. So let take another value of s. S is equal to 4. What is the value of d here? 4 is at 12. So the answer is minus 2. So there is, we cannot take a negative quadruples. We can take 1 quadruple, 4 and 7 quadruples, but not a negative quadruple, a negative double. Therefore, this is option is not there for us. So we cannot have a representation with the 4 individuals or 4 singles. So the problem stops up to here. So out of these combination, which combination is going to give the optimum value, we have to see, verify. So for that, we have to find out the d values. What is d1? We have to find out d1, d2, d3. What is d1 means? D1 means successive differences of the individuals or differentials, sorry, doubles, plus successive difference of doubles and quadruples. So 1 minus 7, I am taking modulus here. So 1 minus 7 plus 7 minus 2. How much this is? 7 minus 1 is 6, 6 minus 6 plus 5 is 11, d is 11. For d2, 2 minus 4, successive difference of singles and doubles plus successive difference of doubles and quadruples. So 4 minus 4 plus 4 minus 4 is going to give how much? It is 2. What about d3? 3 minus 1 plus 1 minus 6. This is 5 plus 2 is 7. So out of these 3, this d2 is having the least value. So we have to choose these set of combinations to get a optimum grade of service value. Okay. So for this kind of diagram here, 11, 2 and 7 are there, right? So where is? I think you can take it. So remember the values. 1, 7. Okay, I'll take it once again. So first case is how much? First case, s is equal to 1, we got d is equal to how much? And q is equal to 172. First case, second case is 2. D is equal to 1 and Q is equal to 6. If you clearly see, sum of these 3 is going to give the availability. 1 plus 7 plus 2, 10. 2 plus 4 plus 4, 10. 3 plus 1 plus 6, 10. So the availability, what is the formula of availability? K is equal to s plus d plus q. So all these satisfying the value of k, availability. Now I am going to draw the grading diagram for these possible cases. We will see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So for the first case, how many individuals are there? So one individual, 7 doubles and cube, 2 quadruples. So this is first, second, third and fourth group. So one single over, doubles are 7. So 7 doubles are there, 1 double, 2 doubles, 3 doubles, 4, 5, 6 and 7 doubles are there and 2 quadruples. Okay, this is the grading diagram for first case. What about second case? For second case, that is the optimum value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, this is 3, 2, 1. How many singles are there? So, 2 singles are there. How many doubles are required? 4 doubles are required. 1 double, 2 double, 3 double, and 4 doubles. So 4 doubles. How many quadruples? So 4 quadruples. Now see the availability. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So totally 20 runs are there. Okay. With the availability, how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Always availability is 10. 2 plus 4 plus 4. For any group, it is 10. So this is about successive grouping. What is D here? D is the sum of successive differences for these graders. The best grading is having the smallest value of D. In our problem, D is having the lowest value, so we are choosing that as our best performance circuit. So next one is comes under other types of gradings, skipped gradings and homogeneous grading. So why you are taking like this means, here in the previous case we are assuming that selector hunter is going to select the outlets from in an order, first one, second, third and so on. So but it is not possible in real time. In the real time it may select any one of the trunk. Okay, in that case we may not get a proper order, singles first, then doubles, then quadruples. You are not seeing like that. You are seeing something like some singles, some double and skipped double. This is skipped double. It is taking common the fourth and second and third and first. In this case, first and fourth, second and third. Here the order is not at all uniform. That is called as skipped type of grading. And another homogeneous. So here the order repeats. Homogeneous, the order repeats for successive stages. Last one is trophic capacity of in grading. So for ideal grading, the total trophic, if it is taken as A, then which carrying n trunks, then occupancy of each rung is A by N, obviously, right? So for n rungs, what is the, if 10 rungs are there, okay, if it is handling a uniform topic, what can I can say? I can say it as A by 10 for each rung. That is a topic handled by each rung, A by 10. If similar here also, if A is Erlang here, A is the topic intensity, Erlang, which is handling n rungs, therefore, for each rung, the occupancy is A by N. The probability that K trunks busy is, how to get the K trunks as busy? So occupancy power K. So that is going to give the B. So from this what can find? Number of trunks required to carry A traffic is AB 4 power minus 1 by K is the formula. But in general cases, we will not take ideal grading. So in case of non-ideal grading, this formula will vary separately, but practically AK plus N minus K into B power 1 by K. So where AK is the fully availability, so you have to get this value from the table, what you seen earlier. We have seen one table, right? For fully availability, what is the, for this BOS value, what is the traffic intensity with how many trunks. So we have to take that value here. In the previous case it is, for 10 trunks it is, for 15 trunks it is 8.1, okay. So the one problem is given here, find the traffic capacity of a 2 group grading if B is equal to 0.01. So for B 0.01, what is the value you can take? N is 20, for the previous problem you have taken, right? For 2 groups, N is 20, K is 10 is availability, and B is equal to 0.01, that is your grid of service value, okay. So from the table, we have seen that for 16, it is 8.1 approximately, because 15 it is 8.1, we are taking it as for 16. So 8.1 plus, this is 20, this 20 minus 10, and 0.01 power 1 by 10 is going to give the final value of our traffic handling capability of the trunks. Okay, in the next class, we will